Hey you guys, it's me, Casey. I am going to record a video today. Remember last time that I recorded a video just yesterday, about half of it cut off. And that was the part of what I was warming, what I've been warming. And so I just wanted to go through that with you guys so that I can throw some of these clamshells away. And the reason that I go through these are twofold. The first reason is that if some of them are active in the catalog and it's not something that you've smelled before, I kind of want to give you an impression. Maybe you really identify with the way that I sniff things out. And so it might make you want to try something. Or you might think that I am like a total nut and that we don't agree at all. And so maybe if you see that I don't like something, you immediately want to order it. So there's that. And then the second thing is that some of the things that I've warmed are no longer available. They might be limited time offers or prior scent of the months, or just things that you can't get anymore, get right now. But the reason that I tell you about them is because we have Bring Back My Bar, which I talked about in my last video. And you can keep a list of things that sound like, you know, something that you might enjoy so that when it is time to vote for Bring Back My Bar that you know, hey, this is something I really would like. Or you could do the opposite, which is, man, that is not something that is going to be on my list. So this is what I've been warming. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is this. This is from the Find Your Happy Wax Collection. It's called Wild, Barefoot, and Free. That's my little ad. She's wonderful. I love her. So it's Wild, Barefoot, and Free, and it was a green colored wax. You can't see it now, but it was green. And I love this one. I put it in my Scentsy Club, and it will stay in my Scentsy Club. It smells beautiful. So to me, it's like a, it's definitely a green note. So it's kind of like fresh, dewy grass, like a picture yourself. My youngest, that one, Adeline, was in soccer for one full season. And she was super great at it. And she just hated every single minute of it, but she was really good. I don't know. Anyway, so it smells like that, like when you had one of those early morning games and we'd go set up our little camp chairs and it was like kind of just still wet, dewy grass and the grass was still kind of mowed and it was like a sweet green smell. Oh, I like love it. I love it. It definitely is sweet, definitely is green. It would be a super good mixer. So for me, you could put this with like any kind of fruity scent. You could put it with any kind of floral scent and it would really complement either of those things. I had it in my open concept. So that's like my living room area, which is kind of, you know, like large. It's open to my stairs and my kitchen area. And it performed really well. I also put it in my bedroom and I really liked it in my bedroom. It was a like really just nice ambiance smell. It's not gonna like knock you down, blow you out of your house kind of smell. But I mean, sometimes you really want that. You just want to like smell something sweet, clean, nice. So this, I highly recommend. So that's Wild, Barefoot, and Free. The next one I'm gonna tell you about is Baked Apple Pie. So, and this, I still have two cubes. So it's kind of a tannish colored wax. So this is like super popular. If you're you have the Scentsy Club, you can get a brick of this. So this is the first time I've melted it, but I was looking at it. You can see pore dates on the inside right here. It's like etched in there. And I was looking at it when I recorded this the first time. And it says it's from 12/17/2019. So I've had this almost a year. And this was my first bar that I'd purchased. Just know that Scentsy bars keep pretty well. I keep mine in a box or I have some like open containers up there. Let me see. You can see them way up there. That's my, this is my Girl Scout room. So I have a bunch of storage and then up on top, I have all of my bars. I try and keep them in kind of an open space so that they don't start to smell like the bars next to them. I find if you put them like in those plastic like shoe boxes with the top that they kind of start to meld their smells, which is not terrible, but I mean, I just, when I want baked apple pie, I don't really want it to smell like you know, while they're foot and free. So I try and keep them kind of separated in like open air areas. And I turn this light off. I make sure that they don't get hot, that sort of thing. So anyways, like, so I've had this for a year almost. And I decided that it was time to warm it. So a lot of people warm this in summertime. For me, it is definitely a fall scent. And I know it's not fall. I know that we're in the middle of still second summer in Texas. But I am wishing and hoping for fall, not just because the heat can be unbearable, but because I'm just hoping that if we can move on to a new season, maybe things will be just a little bit better. I mean, it's been a rough couple of months in this year. So anyways, this is baked apple pie, and this is so good. This is like exactly baked apple pie. You get all of the notes. So the first thing that I get is like that cinnamon apple, like the filling. It's not a crispy apple. It's like an apple that has been baked in its own juices. It's like cinnamon and apple, so good. But you can get a pie crust note. Like you can smell that like butter and crust note. Like it is baked apple pie. If you are not a cinnamon fan, do not buy this. This has cinnamon in it. But if that doesn't offend you, it is beautiful. I love everything about this. Like this will be a repurchase for me. I put it in my open concept and it was fabulous. Like it smelled like apple pie, and it was, my whole room smelled like apple pie. So it was very, very strong, good performer, lasted a long time. It has my votes. So very nice. So the next one that does not have my vote, this is gingerbread donut. And I also looked on this one. I'm pretty sure this is from, let's see, it's this way. August 30th of 2018, it was poured. And so gingerbread donut, I still have 4 cubes. It will take me the rest of my life to get rid of these. So, gingerbread donut. Okay, so this I put upstairs in my kids' room. This one, I have 4 and a mini. Okay, so that's not too bad. I put 1 cube in each of those and I cut it with this. So I'll tell you about this in a second, but this gingerbread donut is like sickeningly sweet. Like I can smell butter and sugar and caramel.
I don't like that smell.
And Adeline says she doesn't like that smell, but it's super strong. Like if you want something that you can taste while you're warming it, this is it. Like I usually put 2 cubes in every one of my warmers. I just put 1 cube in every warmer. Mm. And
hey, listen, I'll come see you in a minute if you can give me some privacy. Thanks.
So this is super, super strong. Like it's heavy bakery. Like you can smell caramel heavy, super sugary. This is just a no-go for me. I cannot. So what I did is this is Walmart wax, okay? This is vanilla bean buttercream. And you might ask, well, why didn't you use Scentsy? Okay, well, let me tell you why. I really like vanilla bean buttercream. I have a couple of ours from Scentsy. It's really good. I like it really on its own. It can mix with anything. But when I have a scent that I really hate, like I really do not like this scent, I hate to use it like with something that I love, which I love vanilla bean buttercream. And so I feel like that's wasting a good scent for a really bad scent. So I was hoping if I did 1 cube of this and then 1 cube of this Walmart wax, that it would like mellow this down so that I didn't just get sick off of it. This is a no-go for me. Because I don't spend my time upstairs, I put it upstairs where my kids and my husband are. And I was down here enjoying baked apple pie. So I put one cube, and then I put one cube of this, hoping that it would, like, mellow it out. It did mellow it out a little bit. But this, I mean, took the day. Like, it's not like I could smell vanilla, really. The thing that I don't like about Walmart wax is that it is not, it has, like, a much higher, like, melting temperature. So it leaves my warmers kind of not that great. Like, it doesn't melt very well, and it's kind of gummy. So I don't love Walmart wax. Sometimes they have some good smells. So, like, I'm not knocking it. I've bought Walmart wax many times. So I'm not going to say they do have some good smells. I don't think that their smells are, like, very sophisticated. So, like, when I get vanilla bean buttercream from Walmart, it just smells like vanilla. It doesn't have a lot of layers to the smell. And so they're good mixers for me. Like, mixing these at least mellowed this down a little bit, but this still took the day. So I have a few things on hand that I'll use when something is, like, not my jam, but I don't want to use stuff I love. So that's why I used this. But this I would never vote for and bring back my bar ever. If I could, like, give it negative votes, I would. But if you like something that's, like, really, like, you can smell fried donut on this, like, if you like that kind of bakery, and if you want something that, like, people will smell no matter what, this is it. Like, for sure, this is gonna last forever. Okay, like, these four cubes, like, I don't burn things at night, I don't melt things at night, but this is the kind of thing that I'd put in my warmer upstairs at night so that I could get rid of it, because I hate to waste wax. So that's this gingerbread donut. I spent a long time on something I didn't really love. Okay, so this is called My Hero. It's a nice kind of navy colored wax, and this was part of the Father's Day collection, so you can't get this anymore, but it's one of those things that if it sounds like something you'd love, you could vote for and it may come back. So My Hero is beautiful. So I love a masculine scent. Like, I like scents that are just like manly smells. So this is like men's body wash, right out of the shower, like sexy man. It's good. I really like it. I put these smells just in this room and in my bedroom because I just, like, they're sexy smells to me, and I feel like this room is kind of just, like, my room a little bit, and that, like, my bedroom is just for me and my husband. My kids, like, go in there. I mean, it's not, like, private, but it just is, like, one of those smells that, yeah, like, sexy man, getting out of a shower, fresh body wash kind of smell. It does not smell like aftershave. It does not smell like Irish Spring or shaving cream. So those are, like, also masculine smells that are common in the wax world. This is really body wash smell. And it's not Axe. It's not, like, 18-year-old, like, teenager body wash smell. It's, like, Old Spice, like, grown-up man smell. But not old man smell. So I really like it. Good performer. I could smell it in my rooms. I don't use these in open concepts. I would imagine that this would not perform well in an open concept just based on its performance in my other rooms. But it's very nice. It's very nice. So my next one is Jack's Obsession. This smells, this is available right now. But I imagine that when it sells out, it'll be gone. This is the second time it's come back. I did not get it the first time it came around. So this is the first time that I've had it, and it's my first melt. So I don't have any of the notes for any of these. Probably I could do baked apple pie, but anyways, we're past that now. So Jack's Obsession is green apple. So it is an apple scent, but it's green apple for sure. And it also has background notes of cinnamon and woods. I don't know what they are. I don't know what, you know, what spice and woods kind of smell, but you can smell that. It's really nice. It's really nice. I like it. I like apple smells. I'm team apple over team pumpkin. So for all of the people that know what they're talking about that are team apple, this is a good apple scent. It's different than the other apple scents that we have. The other apple scents, like Johnny Appleseed or Apple Cherry Strudel, things like that, are red apples, like sweet apples. This is like a tart apple. It's very pretty. So it's a pretty decent performer. I have it in my bedroom right now. And I can smell it when I walk in the room. It doesn't, it's not a powerhouse to me. Like, it doesn't come in through my, you know, hallway or whatever. It stays in the room that it's in, which is fine. It doesn't have to travel for me. It's fine. Like, it's a good, decent performer. And it lasts. But it's also, like, really nice to have something that's different than, like, pumpkin. So, it's good. This Halloween Town, new scent this year, came out when Jack's Obsession returned, and this will be in my club, my friends. It is a nice, like, purpley blue wax, and it is, like, goodness, it's great. So people say that, like, this smells like this, but stronger. That is not at all what I get. This is, like, wood forward. Like, it has a nice wood smell. And I, like, kind of like wet wood smell to me. It has a spice, it has a fruit note, but what I smell mostly first, like wood first for sure. Wet wood first for sure. And then maybe some kind of berry or like tart berry kind of note. I don't know what it is, like I said. And then some spice, but I think the spice is kind of mixed with the wet wood smell to me, and it is good. It's in my open concept, like, living room area, and when I walk in the house or walk from another room into it, I love it. It is beautiful. And I'm day two melt, and I'm not changing my wax out. I have more of these bars, but I don't need to change it yet. It's really good. It sticks around. I don't think it's offensive. When something's offensive, my husband will say immediately or just go turn off all the warmers. And so, which is super annoying because I'll tell you in a second, but I use pluggy things for my warmers. I use these Wi-Fi plugs. I'll tell you about in a second. And he just turns off the toggle switch. So then my Wi-Fi plugs don't work. So anyways, I'll tell you about that in a second. But Halloween Town will be in my club. I love this and it will stay in my club. Like, I want this all through the winter months. So good. It's like a wood scent, which is my jam. So, and then the last thing that I am warming upstairs in my kids' area is apple cherry strudel. And when you guys saw me open this, I told you it's like a really fake cherry smell. And warming, it smells less fake to me. Like, it's not sickeningly sweet. It's still warming, so maybe I should give it a little bit of time before I give you my full impression, but it's just okay for me. I don't hate it. Like, on cold, I hate it. Okay, so on cold, like, if this is what it, like, it smelled like cherry syrup, like cough syrup to me with like some bakery note, that was not my thing. But it's better now, in my opinion. It's better warming than it is on cold. So there's that. But I have it upstairs. So maybe I'll give you my second impressions after I give it more than just a day to warm. So that's what I've been warming. So let me know what you think. What have you been warming? What do you guys think of any of the new stuff that you got? I did get notice that our party haul has shipped and it should be here Monday. So I will make every effort to get you guys your things super quick because I know you've been waiting and I appreciate you guys being patient. The other thing I wanted to show you is how I deal with my Scentsy warmers. So I have warmers. Let's see, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have 5 downstairs and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, well, 4 and a mini upstairs. And I don't keep them on all the time because I do not want to be melting wax while I'm sleeping. So that's just me. Some people keep their warmers on all the time. They're perfectly safe to do that. If you're using the right bulb, you're fine to warm all the time. But a lot of my warmers have lights in them. And so obviously when I'm sleeping, I don't need that. I don't use like this room, my Girl Scout room, in the middle of the night. So I have mine set up on these Wi-Fi plugs. So this is my Wi-Fi plug. It has a little button. I got a 4-pack. So I got this 4-pack from Amazon for like $24, I think. And so what I do is I attach them to my Alexa so my kids can say, Alexa, turn on the Scentsy. And it's part of all of the Scentsy in the house. So when they say that, it turns on or off all of the Scentsy in my house. So all 10 warmers that I have. But I have them programmed to turn on automatically. I have them programmed to turn on automatically at 4:30. When we were living real life, my kids were at daycare. My husband was at work. I was at work. So he would get home about 5. So if we turn it on at 4:30, by 5, the house would be smelling great. And then they turn off automatically at 10. So now that we've been home, what happens is my kids get ready and start doing their virtual schooling. And probably by 9:15, one of them has asked Alexa to turn on all the Scentsy because they love the smells too. I let them pick their smells. Unless it's something that I'm like trying to get rid of, like gingerbread donut. And so if it's like that, then they get the luck of the draw because I pay the bills. And so they turn on the Scentsy by about 9:15 and they turn it off. The one in my daughter's room, Charlotte's room, doesn't have a light, so it does not bug her. But the one in my little one's room, Addie, that you guys saw earlier, she, hers has a light. It's the, I don't know. It was the warmer of the month in July with like all the stars. It's blue. I don't remember what it's called, but it has light. And so it's really a dark warmer. She really could keep it on because she has a huge, like bright nightlight, but for whatever reason in her mind that needs to turn off. So between 8:30 and 9, I lose my Scentsy power. Sometimes they can turn it off for their room. So they say, turn off Adeline's Scentsy, you know, Alexa, turn off Charlotte's Scentsy. And then I get to have my downstairs Scentsy still going. Sometimes they turn it all off, which is fine. So that's how I keep mine going, is that I just get these Wi-Fi plugs and it just does it automatically so that I don't have to worry about it. I will say one thing about these Wi-Fi plugs. I love them because I don't have to think about turning it on and off my Scentsy. It just automatically does it so that when people come into my house, they think it smells great, which I love. But if you have a wall fan diffuser, here's what happens, is you plug this in to your wall fan, to your wall, and then you plug the wall fan diffuser into here, and it will automatically turn off your wall fan diffuser when you have it programmed, which is great because for these little pods, you get about 120 hours, and I don't want it smelling when I'm sleeping, and I don't want to lose that scent, and it can be expensive then. So it will automatically turn off your wall fan diffuser, but it will not turn it back on because the wall fan diffuser, instead of having a toggle switch, which you can just keep on, has a little button, and you got to push the button to turn it on. Now, that didn't bother me. So when I have my wall fan diffuser, which I kept on my stairway until I gave it to my mom, I still had it plugged into one of these, and then it would turn off automatically so that I wouldn't forget and it wouldn't run through the night. But then when I was ready to smell the smell, I would have to go and push the button to turn it on. Totally worth it to me to save the scent so that I didn't, like, I wasn't wasting it. But turning it off was something I would forget because I just would get kind of nose blind to it, or I would just forget because it was on my stairs. Like, if I wasn't right there, like, you can't hear those wall fan diffusers, so it just, I didn't remember. So I liked having this still because it would turn off. I just had to remember to go turn it back on. For me, totally worth it. So that's everything. I will have a gigantic haul on Monday. I am going to open it and smell some things for you. I won't open warmers that don't belong to me because they're for customers and I haven't gotten their permission to open them, but still like a super fun time. So that'll be my next video. Hopefully I will upload it on Monday. I hope you guys have a great weekend. I hope that you stay safe and you're enjoying time with your family and cleaning, which is what I get to do next. Yay! thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions, comment down below and let me know what you've been warming. Talk to you later. Bye, guys.